All right, part two. Marie knew I was married and had kids. She knew my whole life story. I had told her everything. This was unusual for me. I didn't often confide in women, not even Georgie. That was because I didn't trust women. I used women. Women mystified me and I was scared to death of them. Bullshit. I felt it was normal to do whatever I wanted with them. I didn't feel bad or guilty about that. In fact, I thought it was my right as a man to do anything I wanted. Women had hurt me so many times, rejected me and laughed at me. I guess Freud would say all went back to my mother, and he may have been right. I did have issues with my mother for many years. On the other hand, Nanny and Moo were women who had done right by me. I loved and trusted them. Who knows what was going through my mind? Maybe I was just a selfish asshole. Yeah, you know what? Sometimes the simplest explanation is the easiest and the one that makes the most sense because of Occam's razor. You're just a selfish asshole, Stevie. All right. I think our affair went on for more than 2 years. Every time I was in Evergreen, I stayed with Marie. She was very loving and trusting, giving me what I didn't get at home. Yeah, I mean, she didn't give you a lack of accountability. At home, you were accountable for things, and you had responsibilities, and probably didn't have that with Marie. She was smart enough to see what I needed, a quiet place to just be myself where I could get attention and be mothered. I missed that with Georgie. By now, the family was in total turmoil, and I couldn't stand being home. I couldn't see any wrongdoing on my part, only everyone else's. I mean, he was an absolute failure as a father and as a head of household, and took no responsibility for anything, didn't get shit done that needed to get done, mostly just felt like everyone else, why does it have to be me? And, you know, when you're a dad and you're head of household and shit needs to get done, like, the buck stops here, right? Like, I don't know what to say. If you can't handle it, like, you're going to have a hard time having a family. I don't know what to say. It doesn't matter if you're a man or a woman. If you're the head of household and you got to get shit done and things have to be taken care of, you either take care of it or else you lose your stuff. You lose your family. You lose your relationships. People get upset and frustrated. So he didn't want any responsibility and he wanted to just, you know, bang some woman and hang out in her pottery shed. And she let him do that. So that's why he liked it there. No bills to pay over there. No family or teenagers or kids to discipline, and no responsibilities of a wife that need to be tended to. I mean, no wonder he liked it over there. It was just a party. Marie was fixing up her house, and one time she needed help putting a floor in one of her rooms. I bailed. Yeah, there we go. I would let her help me, but my selfishness wouldn't allow me to help her. I was just too full of myself. At the time, I had no problem with my behavior. I mean, like, he, you know, when there was actual work to get done, like, putting some tile on a floor, man, that's like a couple hours of work, maybe, tops, but it just wasn't fun. I was about 38 at the time, and Marie was a few years older. Since she had her go-around as a parent, we never considered pregnancy and took no precautions. Of course, I never had any. I think he means condoms. So they were not being careful. One day, she gave me the news. She was pregnant. How could this happen? How could she be so irresponsible? It's the woman's job to do the worrying about this kind of shit. How could she fuck up my life? Georgia would kill me if she found out about the free-thinking chick who had no thought of for my welfare. I didn't go back to Evergreen for a while, at least not to Marie's house. While she was pregnant, my dad died. I ran away to California, got my DUI, stole the U-joints, and in general lost my mind. Yeah, that explains. So he had this additional stressor that he didn't even talk about during that chapter earlier in the book, where meanwhile he's doing all this crazy shit with my family and just generally being an irresponsible douchebag. I mean, meanwhile he's got Marie over here who's pregnant. So he had a bunch of shit going on, and he had created these compartments in his life, and rather than deal with anything, he took off and went to California. What a dickhead. Oh, what a dick. All right. My divorce papers from Georgia were waiting for me when I returned from my little walkabout, as I called these flights from reality. So he took off to California. He's in California. My wife files for divorce. My mother files for divorce. My mother doesn't even know about Marie or Cody or any of this other shit going on. She filed for divorce because he was just an irresponsible douchebag, and she probably suspected he was sleeping around. But whatever. Totally devastated by the loss of my marriage, my family, and still not taking any responsibility for any of it, I ran to Marie. All I did was cry and whine about how much I loved Georgie, how much I wanted to go home. She listened to me, she consoled me, and she helped me through my pain. I don't understand the motivation for Marie in this situation, to be honest with you, other than she just liked my dad. But why she would want this loser is beyond me. All right. By now, Marie's mother had come to stay with her during the pregnancy. She was always complaining about health problems and calling the doctor with the same useless symptoms. One day, the mother was not feeling well. No one paid any attention because she had cried wolf too many times. Then she suddenly dropped dead in Marie's living room. Whoa, what the fuck? With the out-of-wedlock child coming soon, Marie had more than me to worry about. Yet, unselfishly, she listened to me, never trying to control the situation or use her problems to sway my feelings. She just did what she felt was right. I didn't see it. I was too wrapped up in myself. I mean, this is his perspective like 40, 30 years later or whatever, but who knows what. I'm sure Marie was. She just lost her mother in her house. She's looking at a pregnancy with a child that was unexpected. She's got a loser boyfriend. I use that term loosely. That's like basically just a parasite living in her house at this point, I'm guessing. Yeah, she sounds like she did him a solid. He doesn't have anything negative to say about the situation. Time passed. I got divorced. I lost my mind. I drank. I got fired from the Love Bennetts. Even after all I had done, all the pain I had put her through, Marie still cared about me. I don't know if she loved me. I can't remember her saying it. I know I never said it to her. Love is something you do, not something you say. I stayed away and she had the baby. Okay. That's it. Oh, okay. Here's the thing about Cody. I'm just going to keep going because this is not, that was not a long chapter. And by Cody. Haunted by Marie and by Cody. Clever. She named him Cody. His family was furious with her, but she was strong and did the right thing. I don't know what he means by the right thing, by having the baby, I guess. I guess he was. I know he was pro-choice, but whatever. She did the right thing that she decided for herself. I'm sure there must be some more children out there that I followed, but this little guy was the only one I knew of for sure. By now, I was living alone in a little house in Windsor, not far from our old place where Georgia and I had lived. I had wanted to be close to Keith and still was hurting from losing my family or what was left of it. Tiger and Lisa had moved to Atlanta to live with their natural father. Only Keith and Georgie still lived in Colorado, but not close to me. I mean, he lived in town. We lived about 4 miles away from him. Lisa and Tiger went to go live with their father because our house was a fucking train wreck. My mother, we were basically living on welfare. My mother had picked up a job at the university where she was getting her degree, where she was paid not a whole lot of money to do like encoding type stuff. And we couldn't afford to pay, we could barely afford to pay our bills. Like, and I'm sh I don't know the full financial situation. I'm pretty sure my dad left some debts for us too when he took off. And my mother was having to deal with all that while supporting three kids. And so when Tiger and Lisa left, I'm sure that it was probably emotionally traumatizing and upsetting. But Tiger was a psychopath, dangerous psychopath. And Lisa was, not to like armchair diagnose, but like a borderline personality disorder. So she was incredibly manipulative and difficult to be around, just in general. So when the two of them were like, hey, we're gonna go live with their dad because we don't like it here anymore, I'm sure my mother was upset but also happy. I mean, they were both into meth too at that time. So my mother was probably like happy that they were not gonna be a financial burden and that she could get her own life together. It was a weird time for me because I didn't really feel particularly upset by any of it. It was just something that was happening. They would go and visit their dad all the time. It just seemed like an extended stay to me. And frankly, I was glad to have my brother out of the house because I hated the guy. Lisa, I was fairly fond of when I was a kid. Yeah, it was weird. It was a weird time. I spent a lot of time alone after that. A lot of time alone. It was basically me and my dog wandering cornfields for years until, for a couple years there, until we moved back to Kansas City. So I spent a lot of time alone. All right. And him, he was only in Windsor for like a year before he went off and did his own thing. And I don't even remember what he did. I think that's right around the time he went down to South Carolina. All right, one Sunday, so this is while he's still in Colorado. One Sunday, Marie came by with Cody. He was about a year old and just looked like my baby pictures. I had a gig playing the piano at the Marriott Hotel on Sundays for brunch and invited them to come with me. I played, Cody did what babies do, and Marie smiled and listened to me. We ate together and talked. She had no anger or resentment towards me. That I find hard to believe. She probably did not share it with him, but I have no doubt that there was some frustration there. All right, I'm going to pause there for a second.